Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. When we talked about the display property, I told you guys how there are two important properties called flex and grid. And this one is about flex, how you can use it to style your HTML elements on your web page. The word flex is used here because it aligns and distributes the space between the items even when their sizes are unknown. The main idea of Flexbox is to change the item sizes to fill the available space. If you remember from the position, a parent element wraps around children elements like this. In Flexbox, the parent element is called the flex container, and the children elements are called the flex items. And in order to use the Flexbox correctly, you gotta add some extra properties along with display flex. There are a lot of properties you can use to your container and the items, but some are used more than others. So we're going to talk about the ones that are used more frequently. First, to use the Flexbox, you got to set your parent as displayFlex. The first one is FlexDirection. It determines the direction in which your items are aligned. There are four options you can use to your FlexDirection: Row, Row Reverse, Column, and Column Reverse. So like the name says, row aligns your items left to right in a row. And row reverse is row, but reversed, so it aligns your items right to left. Column aligns your items vertically from top to bottom, and column reverse is column, but reversed, so it aligns your items from bottom to top. Let's look at this with some examples. Default is row. If I change to row reverse, you can see the alignment changes. And then I can set it as column. In column reverse, it aligns your items bottom to top. Like that. The second one is flex wrap. By default, all the flex items are going to try to fit into one single line. But you can change that and allow them to wrap around the container. There are three options you can add to your flex wrap: wrap, wrap reverse, and no wrap. First, I'm going to add some items to help you understand this better. You can see how the items shrink instead of going around the container. Let's add some flex wrap options to see how it changes. You can see how it wraps around the container. There's also wrap reverse, which wraps around the container in a reverse order. There is also no wrap, which is a default property. It does not wrap. Like that. The third one is justifyContent. It defines the alignment along the flex direction. There are a lot of options you can use, but the ones that are used more frequently are flex start, flex end, center, and space between. I removed one item to help you understand justifyContent better. The first one is flex start. This is the default. It aligns your item leaning toward the beginning of the flex direction. So nothing changes. Next one is flex end. It aligns your item leaning towards the end of your flex direction. Like that. The third one is center. It aligns your item at the center of your flex direction. The last one is space between. It sets your first item at the very beginning of your flex direction, the last item at the very end, and the rest are distributed evenly. Like that. The last one is align items. This defines the alignment along the other direction. So if you set your flex direction as a row, align items will define the alignment along the column. There are three options that are used more frequently: flex start, flex end, and center. Let's look at this with some examples. The first one is flex start. It aligns item towards the start of the line. Next one is flex end. It aligns your item at the end of the line. The last one is center. It aligns your item at the center of the line. I personally use this option a lot. Like that. And now let's talk about the ones you can add to your flex items. A lot of times you just gotta add some properties to your parent element only, but sometimes you gotta add the element to your children elements to use flexbox correctly. There are a lot of properties you can add to your flex items, but let's talk about the ones that are used more frequently. The first one is flexGrow. If you remember from the beginning, I told you how the main idea of Flexbox is to change the item sizes to fill the available space. If you set a specific item to flexGrow, that specific item will increase in size to fill the available space. Let's take a look. You see how the second item filled you with a little space like that. The next one is flex shrink. If you set an item to flex shrink, you can tell which item to shrink first if the container gets too small. You can see how the second one shrinks first. That was a lot, but I hope you got the gist of it by looking at the examples that I provided. But once you start writing code, it's gonna come to you very naturally. And as always, if you wanna learn about something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.